Hello student, welcome to the next lecture of the digital signal processing. We are going to study here the different frequency responses for the different types of windows. Let's see the next type of window, that is Hamming window. This is the second type of window which we are going to study, HAMMING, Hamming window. So again the approach is same. We need to obtain H of n with the help of the multiplication of HD of n and the related window function. So for the Hamming window, the function will be given as, let's say the indication which we use for Hamming window, that is HM for Hamming. WHM of n is equal to 0.54 minus 0.46 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1, where n is ranging from 0 to m minus 1. M is nothing but actually the length of the filter, which already we have seen. So this is what the length of the filter. But what about the else cases? Means for this, it is 0 for elsewhere or the rest of the cases. So this is what the rectangular window function which we have seen in the earlier case, but right now it is Hamming window function. This is Hamming window function, 0.54 minus 0.46 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1. Now let's see its frequency response for the Hamming window. If we consider, let's say the length of the filter is m is equal to 25, so it will range it like one simple cluster, this, so it is ranging like this. So these are the various values. Let's say it is for m equal to 25 case. So since it is m equal to 25, so obviously it will range from minus 12 to plus 12. So for simplicity, sometimes it may be simply varied from 0 to 24 only. So let's consider it for the 0 to 24 case. So obviously 0 to pi will be considered. So when it is symmetric, it is how it is given, so 4 pi by n, and this is nothing but the WHM e raised to j omega, means frequency response. Similarly, for the low pass filter using Hamming window, one can draw it like this. Let's proceed only to the this particular part. So here, this is the dotted line indicates the ideal filter response. So it can be plotted like 0.5 pi, that is omega c. So this is what the response for the Hamming window. Similarly, we can proceed for other type of window, that is Hanning window. So for the Hanning window, the expression is slightly different. So let me write the name of the next type of window, that is Hamming window, HANNING, Hamming window. So for the Hamming window, the function is, let's indicate it with the different notation, WHN of n. It is given like 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 pi n by m minus 1. This is what the response, or we can say the function for the Hamming window. For the Hamming window, the approach is slightly different. The cutoff frequencies are almost the same. if we say again m equal to 25 ks for the hanging window, it will again range like this only. So this is like a mountain, again it will be stabilized, then it will be decreased. So this is for minus 12 to plus 12. Let's say if the length of the filter is m equal to 25, so this is how it will be varying. Similarly, for the WHN of omega or e raised to j omega case, for this case if we just consider the positive part or the right side part, it will be range like this. So this is what 4 pi by n frequency. In terms of the low pass filter approach, again it will be simplified as a 0.5 pi as a cutoff frequency, same as that of the Hamming window. So this function is quite important to solve the numericals based on the Hamming window. If we go for log magnitude response of the Hamming window, it will be summarized like this. Up to pi it will be specified. This is what 0 dB, and this is nothing but the log magnitude. So it will range from, let's say, minus 120 to 0 dB, and that is nothing but magnitude of WHN e raised to j omega in terms of the dB. So this is about the Hamming window. Let's proceed for the next type of window, that is nothing but the triangular window. Okay, let's see now the next type of window function, that is the triangular window function. As the name indicates, it is the triangular. So the nature is, obviously it is a triangular type of nature. So in terms of the sample values, it will be like this. So triangular nature will be observed. If it is for m equal to 25, again this will range from minus 12 to plus 12, or at the right hand side it will be 0 to 24. So this is what the triangular functions. Next, if I want to plot, let's say, the frequency response of the triangular window function, it is almost same as that of the earlier case. This is how it will be. This frequency will be 4 pi by n. And obviously this is nothing but W, let's say the indication, the suffix this time we are using, that is T for triangular, e raised to j omega. This is how it will be for the triangular. But what exactly the function for this? So for the triangular window, it is WT of n is equal to 1 minus 2 mod n by m minus 1. This is for, let's say, mod n less than m minus 1 case. So this is nothing but actually the triangular window function. Similarly, we will have the another type of window, that is called as a Blackman window. So for the Blackman window, the expression, let's say, it is indicated, or the function WB of n is equal to 0.42 minus 0.5 cos 2 pi n by m minus 1 plus 0.08 cos 4 pi n m minus 1, and obviously n is ranging from 0 to m minus 1. This is nothing but Blackman window function. The response is almost same as that of the earlier cases. Next type of window is nothing but the Kaiser window. So the name is Kaiser window. For the Kaiser window, let's say it is WK of n, it is given like I0 of beta by I0 of alpha. This is applicable for the case when the mod n is less than or equal to q. Or the alternate expression can be given as, for the Kaiser window, that will be like I 0 times alpha square root of 1 minus, this is n by q square divided by I 0 of alpha. So mod of n less than equal to q, and elsewhere it is 0. This is nothing but actually the expression for the Kaiser window. This window is slightly different, where the terms like alpha and q comes in the picture. Here the point to be noted is, based on this alpha parameter, the side lobes which we can observe over here, let's say for this case, the side lobes for any response will be changing. Means for alpha equal to 0, both the numerator and denominator of the window function are 1. Similarly, when the parameter alpha is varied, both the transition width as well as the peak ripple in the side lobe changes. So which can be observed, like when the alpha, let's say this is for alpha equal to 4 case, this is what the side lobes. When we analyze it for alpha equal to 6 case, then it will become like this. So side lobes will be very minor. So this is for alpha equal to 6 case. This is how the alpha, this particular parameter, matters when we want to decrement the side lobes and just want to concentrate only on the major lobe, that is at this central part. So this is how actually the Kaiser window is proposed. Apart from all these windows, from the exam point of view, or mostly asked windows are rectangular window, Hamming window, Hanning window, and at the most triangular window. So thank you everyone. Thank you very much.